भी देखने सकती हूँ।
हेलो एंड ओम साई राम टू ऑल द डिवोटीज। एक्सट्रीमली सॉरी फॉर द डिले ड्यू टू अ पॉलिटिकल रैली ओवर हियर एंड आई होप यू ऑल आर एबल टू हियर मी एंड सी मी क्लियरली एज वेल। ओके सो आई कैन सी मैनी डिवोटीज आर जॉइनिंग फ्रॉम ऑल अक्रॉस द ग्लोब फ्रॉम डिफरेंट टाइम जोन्स फ्रॉम डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड। I hope I'll be able to do justice to the time that you are spending on this live. So, we will get just 59 minutes to cover all the topics, all the questions, to answer all the questions that you all have asked me. And today onwards, I hope I'll be able to sit with you all frequently. I'll be able to interact with you all frequently henceforth. So, without the least delay, I'll be starting with the Q&A session. I have already received lots of questions from the devotees from all across the world, and I can see that I had seen the enthusiasm in the devotees, amongst the devotees from all across the world, from UAE, from USA, from UK, from Australia, from Nepal, Bhutan. Thank you for showing so much interest in our first ever live session, first ever live interactive Q&A session. So now I am taking up the questions. So let's read what are the questions that I have received. So here I can see that most of the devotees have asked about the experiences that I have experienced. Share us a miracle experienced by you. What made you become an ardent Sai devotee? Okay. So since the majority of the questions are related to my experiences, my life experiences, is my audio clear? Hello? I hope you all are able to hear me properly. Hello? I guess my voice is clear enough. All right, thank you so much. So, starting with the experiences, how I became a devotee, it is like it was all Baba's plan. Oh, in fact, I would like to show you that I'm sitting beside Baba himself. He's also attending the live session with all of you. He's able to see all of you over here. He's there. Physically present over here. All right. So the thing actually started with my mother. My mother first started devotion towards Baba. So I was very small at that time. Our Kula Devata is Shri Satya Narayan, Shri Vishnu Ji, and Ma Lakshmi. And our Gram Devi is Ma Bhavatarini from Dakshineshwar Kali Temple, the presiding deity of Dakshineshwar Kali Temple. So, being a Bengali from Kolkata, being of a Bengali background, it is a natural inclination to be devotees of Ma Durga, Ma Kali. So, similarly, even I was a devotee of Ma Durga in my childhood. But my mother initially started devotion towards Baba, and then we got many darshans, realizations. We have witnessed many miracles of Baba. Since then, we started how Baba entered in our life. That is a very big thing. Actually, I have published many articles regarding this in this Instagram platform. But I guess the devotees who are asking me are my new family members over here. So it will be my immense pleasure to retell all those experiences once again for all of you. So it initially started with a fairground, interestingly. So I was at that time very small. I went with my mother to one of the local fairgrounds over here. A fair was organized due to some festival over here during the summer time. it was dedicated to Ma Vindhyavasini, Ma Durga. So her worship was going on in our locality, and dedicated to her, a fair was organized. So in that fair, I visited there with my mother. I was very small then. So in the fairground itself, we found a big paper image of Baba. It was not framed, it was a paper photo. So somehow that photo attracted my mother. At that time, let me tell you, we did not know who he was. We did not know his name was Sai Baba. We did not know him at all. Yes, we had seen his photos at many shops. We had seen him at many places. But we did not know who he was. Because in West Bengal at that time, I'm talking about around 2002 or 3. So at that time, the fame of Baba was not that much in Kolkata. So we saw a paper photograph of Baba in that fairground, and my mother purchased it. Somehow Baba attracted her like a magnet. So we brought him home. We had a calendar of Ganpati hanging on our room, the room in which we stayed. So there we applied adhesive and tape, and then we pasted Baba's photograph on the top of Ganpati ji, and we started worshipping him there itself in that paper photograph form. So it initially started like that, and then my mother started her devotion towards Baba. And then how, I don't know, Baba arranged, how skillfully he arranged the circumstances that we came across Sai devotees, and they started interacting with my mother. They introduced us to Baba, that he is Sai Baba of Shirdi, whom you are worshipping. Some people came to our home who had visited Shirdi earlier, and then they shared about Baba, their realizations about Baba. They gave us DVDs of Baba's Aarti, and we used to play them. And like that, gradually our devotion towards Baba had grown like anything. I believe that it is because of the Rinanubandh that Baba had with us since our previous births, since our innumerable previous births, that we have come together. So in this life also, that is why it did not take much time for Baba to give us the reminiscences of his existence in our previous lifetimes. So it began like that. We started worshipping Baba. My mother observed fast on the Thursdays. We did not know that Baba did not like fasting. We came to know about this late in 2013 or 14, I guess. So when we read in Sai Satcharitra, before that we did not know about that. So initially what my mother did during the Thursdays is, she fasted till the afternoon after offering Naivedya, Bhoga, to Baba. And then we used to partake that prasad, and we used to break our fast. So from the morning, my mother did not even drink water. She observed strict fasting, and then she used to cook lovingly for Baba, puris, then kheer. She used to cook lots of like veg items, sabzi. So like every Thursday in the year 2005, my mother did the same thing. She prepared everything. At that time, my sister was not born. She was born in 2006. So she is a gift of Baba in our family. How she came, let me narrate that incident and how Baba gave his physical darshan to us. So it started like this, that my mother worshipped Baba on the Thursday. She observed fast from the morning. She cooked for Baba. She cooked lots of dishes, sweet dishes for Baba. And then after offering them to Baba, we used to have them on. So there's a political rally going on for election over here. So they offered the bhoga. My mother offered the bhoga. She was cooking the bhoga. Sorry for the interruption. So, okay. So she, just let me know if there is any disturbance over here, okay? So she offered the bhoga. She was cooking the bhoga. Sorry, so sorry for the interruption. So she was cooking the bhoga. At that time, a fakir came to our doorstep. The door was open. So he came and stood in front of our door. He was wearing the exact dress that Baba used to wear. He had donned a kafni on his body. He was wearing a turban on his head. He had a jholi, a sack on his shoulders. It was a blissful form, like just like we see Baba. So he was just there was total resemblance with Baba. So yes, I'll definitely share that story. thank you so much. So he came with the kafni on his body. He was totally in his original form. He stood in front of our house. So my mother, she never saw any such mendicant over here in Kolkata, since people did not know Baba so much over here. And that person, he did not go to any other person's house. He came directly to our house to beg some food from our house. So it was already a very shocking sight for us that why didn't he go to the neighboring houses? And our neighboring houses are all occupied by our relatives in themselves. So even they were wonderstruck that how come he ignored all the houses and he entered our house only. And at that time my mother was preparing meal for Baba himself. So what he did is he came and he said, "Ma, give me some rice and some dal in separate plastic packets. Please don't mix them up." So my mother was more than happy to serve him. So my mother, affectionately, she addressed him as Baba. So she said, "Yes, Baba, I'll definitely give you." So she started preparing the things. She went into the kitchen. She took two plastic bags, and in one plastic bag, she put some rice, and on the other one, she put some pulses. And she gave some raw vegetables also. She gave some potatoes, some brinjal. Being Thursdays, so those vegetables were available at our house, and she gave them to him. So he accepted them very happily. And then what he did is he opened the jholi which he carried, and opening the jholi, he showed his collection for the day, and he said that, "See, this is what I have. A bit of rice and a bit of pulses that also mixed together. Now see, I need to sort it out. I need to cook them. I have to take all the pains myself to cook it." And when my mother noticed the collection of the fakir carefully, what he had collected from all the houses, she saw that the rice and the pulses that were offered to him were of very cheap quality, and they had like bugs or insects in them, eating them. So my mother said, "How will you eat them? It's already not a good quality for you to eat." So he said that, "I'll manage somehow. I'll sort everything out. I'll first of all segregate the rice and pulses and then eat it. But since you have given this best quality rice and pulses to me, that also separately at my request, I'll cook this today and I'll eat." So my mother said, "Okay, you wait for a while over here." So we generally offer bhoga to Lord Shri Krishna in silver utensils. He has a silver bowl in which we offer him sweets. So a sweet was already offered to him at that time. So my mother took the Krishna Prasad and she gave it to him in that silver bowl itself. So he ate that sweet with great relish, and then he blessed my mother heartily, and then he went from there. How he went, where he went, we don't know. We had asked our neighbors, our relatives, whether he had visited any of their houses. They said no, they had not even seen a fakir pass by. So that cleared our thing that he was Baba. Now my father at that time was not a Sai devotee. He was a devotee of Ma Kali and Baba Loknath, who is a famous saint over here at West Bengal. So he used to worship Ma Kali and Baba Loknath. Their photos were there at our shop, and he used to worship the two deities only. So my mother had requested that, you please install a photo of Lord Sai Baba at your store. He said that no, my store is not a tea stall, that I'll install so many DTs, so many pictures of so many DTs at my stall. So I'll not place any other DT except Ma and Baba Loknath. So my mother did not object at all. My mother just requested Baba that you please arrange the circumstances, you do such a miracle, you arrange the circumstances in such a way that my husband becomes devoted to you and his days must begin with your worship and nothing else. And now, at the present moment, at this day, the thing has come true. So, it was all Baba's sheer leela, how he has brought my father to his devotion, to that path. So, hours. I can speak at a stretch for 5 to 6 hours and it can just compile a big book. So I'm just trying to cut it short as much as possible, and I'll also come to the few questions that the devotees have asked to me. So definitely I'll be coming frequently live with all of you. It will be a pleasure for me to interact with you all. I'll share one leela in each live session. So coming back to the story, he went away at that time. My father came back home for the afternoon lunch. So at that time, my mother, she narrated the whole story to him, that these are the incidents that happened. A fakir, a mendicant, came to our house for begging alms, and I have given the same to him. I have given these articles and he was very happy to receive them. He has blessed me. So my father was very happy. He said that you have done a great job. So after eating our lunch, what my father has a general habit that he gives the leftover food to the stray dogs. So, and they used to gather in front of our door to have their meals. So at that day also, being a Thursday, 2 to 3 dogs came for having the meals. And my father, he used to serve the meal on a clean concrete slab, which was very clean, of course. My mother used to wash it daily. So he upturned the vessel of leftover food on the slab and the dogs began to eat, just like they eat regularly. And after just offering the food, as my father turned, he saw that the same fakir standing at his back. Now let me make one thing very clear. The apartment building at which we lived at that time had a very long alley. It was a narrow, long lane through which a person had to enter. We stayed at the ground floor, and we were the only users of that road, of that particular lane. So it was very difficult for an aged man to come across that long alley within that short period of time. It was itself a miracle how that person made way through that very narrow and long alley. And he was obviously having a stick in his hand. So my father, he was just shocked that how did he come. So he asked him that, yes Baba, say how I can help you. So he said, no, I already came in the morning. I have had a hearty meal after your wife has offered me the rice and the pulses. So I just came here to suggest to you that please do not feed the dogs on this flat slab. You better arrange for a mud vessel and please give food in that. So my father was like, okay, I'll definitely carry out your orders. I'll execute them now. You just wait a while, because just beside that apartment building was my uncle's sweet shop. So he used to have those mud vessels for selling curd, sweets, rasgullas. So my father went to the sweet shop and he asked for a mud vessel, a big one, to feed the dogs. So what they did is, they gave one mud vessel to my father, earthen pot, like a sort of a thing. So he brought it and immediately he transferred all the contents to the vessel and he placed it in front of the dogs and he fed them. and the dogs ate it with great relish, sumptuously. And then the person, the mendicant, he was standing there. He was waiting for the execution of his orders. So my father said, "Are you happy now, Baba?" So he said that, "Yes, I am more than happy that you have carried out my orders. So keep loving animals like this, serve them well." And the moment my father turned back, he was not there. Now there was no other way to go out. There was only one way, a long alley through which an aged person will take about 1.5 minutes to go out, to walk through. So it was itself a miracle that where did that person go? Where did he disappear? Out of nowhere he came and we saw him. So my father went in and he narrated the entire story to my mother that while eating you had narrated about a fakir who had come to beg alms from you. And now I saw a same fakir wearing the same white attire. He was standing in front of me and he said that feed the dogs in a mud vessel, and now I can't find him anymore after carrying out his orders. So then onwards my father started believing Baba because he had got a physical revelation of Baba. And I guess this was a question asked by one of the devotees of our family that yes, have you got Baba's divine darshan in real? So yes, this was one of the incidents that I just narrated, and this is how he came and he gave his darshan. And after that itself, after his feet, his holy feet touched our house, we got the blessing of my sister, and she was born. And before that we also had some financial constraints and all those things. Those started getting sorted out after Baba's blessings was received, after the entire house was consecrated by Baba's touch. Our days became very much happier. And to narrate another incident, just like one of our devotees reminded me of Baba's eating of aloo posto. So in West Bengal, there is a famous recipe of potatoes with poppy seeds, khaskhasa. We call it the fulkopi aloo posto. And once while we were at Shirdi, my mother received a dream vision that you cook fulkopi aloo posto very well. Please offer it to me as naivedya on Thursdays. So my mother was more than happy. And just after returning home on Thursday, on the following Thursday after we returned home from our Shirdi pilgrimage, my mother cooked fulkopi aloo posto, and I was preparing for doing the Madhyan Aarti at 12 noon. So all the platables, all the eatables were spread out for Baba. All the naivedya was already ready for him to partake. And I was waiting for the clock to strike 12 that I will start the Aarti ceremony, the naivedya offering ceremony. So while waiting, my mother said that don't make Baba wait so much. He has asked me to feed him aloo posto, and I have prepared it with so much affection that I want to feed him with this as soon as possible. You don't make delay. So I was a bit lethargic, I will admit it, that I was waiting for the clock to strike 12 because that was the time for Baba's Madhyan Aarti. At that point of time, that all the bhoga that was there, those things were covered with heavy brass dishes. Those were covered with those brass dishes. And the moment I just turned towards Baba's shrine, one of the dishes which was covering the fulkopi aloo posto dish, it was just like thrown like this towards me. All of a sudden that cover was removed, and with a bang on the floor, with a noise, it was dropped. So I was just shocked that how come it, that such a heavy brass dish that was covering the dish was thrown out so easily. So my mother said, see, I told you that you don't make Baba wait so much. You feed him as soon as possible. You offer the Naivedya and start the aarti just now, right now. And it was around 11:30, 11:45, I started the aarti immediately. And Baba took his dish. And since then, whether it is the season of cauliflower or not, we try to arrange the things and we try to offer him fulkopi alu posto every single Thursday. And even if we miss on some Thursdays, he reminds us. He comes to my mother's dream and he says that today I did not get that dish from you. And similarly, a similar instance to this is like he once came to my mother's dream. We have a general practice of offering him tea every evening. The older members of my Instagram family must be knowing that Baba has tea every evening. He consumes the evening tea every day from our house. So on one occasion, due to some festival or something in our house which was being celebrated, my mother forgot to offer that evening tea to him, to Baba. And that night itself, Baba came to my mother's dream and he said that I did not get the tea from you. Today at evening, I visited your house with an aim to have to drink the evening tea, but I could not have it, unfortunately. So at that day itself, my mother was so she was so guilty that I did not offer Baba the tea. And from the next day, we started offering him the evening tea without any more carelessness, without any more irresponsibility. And I'm getting a request that share some experience from Shirdi. Yes, in Shirdi also, we first visited Shirdi in 2013. I will try to repost all the experiences of my life, which I used to post earlier in this page itself. But it will be very difficult for all of you to scroll that long, because each day we share approximately 9 posts. So it's very difficult to scroll through so many posts and get back to those posts. I'll try to start the series again, but I need some time, because already the Bhakta Lilamrit, the 4 chapters of Dasganu Maharaj, that series is going on. After that series ends, I'll again start publishing my life experiences for the benefit of all the devotees. Because if I start narrating the Shirdi instances in this very live session, I will not be able to answer the questions that I have, that the devotees have asked me, I guess. So if at the end I get time, I'll definitely share one, or else I'll again come to meet you all I'll share with you definitely those realizations, those experiences that we have at Shirdi. Now coming back to the questions that the devotees have asked, I have, share us a miracle experienced by you. What made you become an ardent Sai devotee? These are the experiences and these are the questions that I have already answered in the past few minutes. Okay, so one of the devotees of our Sai family, I am keeping all the devotees anonymous because certain personal questions are also here. Baba, how will I know you are listening to my fears, anxiety? And phobias. Yes, he listens. He listens to everything. Not even the footsteps of an ant or an insect is ignored by him. That does not pass through his... he doesn't even ignore the footsteps of an ant. Just think of his omnipresence, his omniscience, that he listens to all our prayers, whatever we pray. Our silent prayers, our whispers, everything is heard by him. He never ignores our prayers. He is listening, but he will definitely grant your wishes. He will grant your prayers according to your merits and as the time comes. please wait for the right time. He will definitely shower his blessings. He is there to give us blessings. Okay? He is there to give us. His treasury is ever full. And if I do not do the puja of Sai Baba, does Baba get angry? May I know what is the reason for ignoring Baba's seva? Being devotees, even I am answering this question also, that does he listen to our prayers? Being devotees, it is our duty to serve him. Service to Baba is our duty. And protection of the devotees is his duty. So we don't need to teach him his duty. He is all perfect. He is the mine of perfection. We are imperfect. We are human beings. We are filled with imperfections. So our duty is to serve. His duty is to protect. So let us do our duty in a pleasing manner first, and then he will definitely grant our wishes, or not only our wishes, our prayers must be such that they should not involve all the material objects. We should have the spiritual advancement in view as well. Okay, due to heavy household work, you are not able to worship Baba. But we need to bring some time. We are getting time to sleep. We are getting time to eat. I hope it is not a big deal to dedicate at least half an hour a day in front of the altar worshipping the deity. He is definitely listening to your anxieties. He is definitely listening to your phobias. And let me tell you that he will never disappoint you. Yes. Patience is absolutely a necessary thing. It is absolutely required for you to keep patience, to keep faith, and things will show up at the right time. No doubt to his merciful boons, he will definitely bestow his blessings on you whenever the suitable time comes. And it is required on our part to serve him sincerely. Are we that much sincere? We need to question ourselves. That are we that much sincere in chanting his name? Are we that much sincere in serving him? Are we that much sincere in offering our daily services? We must take out a time slot in a day, in the Brahma Muhurta. At that time, our mind is very much peaceful. At that time, there is less disturbance. So, at that time, it is I suggest you that worshipping in the Brahma Muhurta is very meritorious on a devotee's part. It's very meritorious. Om Sai Ram, when will Baba act on my wishes? Patiently waiting for his answers. Okay, so yes, have patience. Baba says, or even Shri Krishna has said in the Bhagavad Gita, that if you are not patient, how will my darbar help you at all? So, in case of spiritual affairs, he is the Brahman Nayak. He knows even the slightest of the desires in our hearts. So, he will definitely fulfill them. We must be ardent on our side, from our side, that how we are going to serve him. How we should pray? This is another question. What must be our approach towards Baba while we ask for something? Suppose, I am asking... I being a student, I am giving an example of the prayers, the sort of prayers students ask. That Baba, please give me admission to some reputed university in some reputed college. So is this the right way to ask God, not to Baba, irrespective of Baba, to any deity, be it Hanumanji, be it Ma Durga, be it Shivji, be it Ma Kali, be it any deity. So, what is the way that how we should approach them? Our approach must be that we should say in this way, like, Baba, if you so wish to grant me the wish of giving me admission in a reputed university, then Baba, please do whatever is fit. I wish this, but it is on you whether you are wanting to fulfill that wish of mine. It is you who will grant the wish. So, you know what is the best thing for me. Of course, your plans are perfect and the best. So, if you so wish to grant me this wish, then kindly, Baba, this is my wish. Please grant me. So, we are no one to order him. We are no one to order him. We will, we must have a different approach in conveying our prayers to Baba. We must convey it like this, that Baba, if you so wish to grant me this wish, this prayer of mine, then Baba, please grant me. We must not say that Baba, dila do, admission dila do is college mein. Ya fir Baba, mujhe ye job lagwa do, please. We are no one to order him. He is the supreme personality. He is the supreme. He is our Sadguru. He knows our minutest of the wishes. He is our mother. Obviously, he will give us the thing which is fit for us to enjoy. So, we must have the patience to receive that gift from him. And we must ask him in the way I said. And I know you all are much more sincere devotees than me, and you will be able to ask him in a much more pleasing way than me. So, it was just a way of approach that we should have towards Baba that I shared with you all just now. Now, another devotee of our Sai family is asking me, what are the benefits of Brahma Muhurta Parayans? Okay, this is a very wonderful question. Just a few minutes back, I was speaking about Brahma Muhurta worship, Brahma Muhurta chanting. It is mentioned in the Shastras, it is mentioned in the scriptures, in the Hindu scriptures, that any worship, any mode of worship, be it be like serving the deity, be it chanting his name, be it parayan of religious scriptures like Bhagavatam, Gita, Satcharitra, it is highly meritorious. The merits that you will get doing worship in the entire day or in the evening is doubled during the Brahma Muhurta. It is said in the Gita that the merits that we gain, the bank balance that we have in our spiritual life is never exhaustible. It never exhausts. Okay? It's inexhaustible. In this material world, we have bank accounts, right? And we save money in them, in the banks. And that money gradually gets diminished as we spend the money. But that is not the case with the spiritual bank accounts that we have. It is eternal. It is inexhaustible. The money that we save in the spiritual bank, the currency of Baba's holy name, Baba's chanting, the religious practices that we daily incur, those are not diminished even after our death. Please mark my words. Even in our next life, those merits will stay fixed in the banks, in our spiritual banks that we have. Okay, so Brahma Muhurta Parayans are absolutely very much meritorious. Not only Parayan, if you are not doing Parayan, it's okay. Doing any sort of religious worship, any mode of serving Baba during the Brahma Muhurta is highly meritorious on the devotee's end. It is highly meritorious, let me tell you. Be it chanting Baba's holy name, be it anything, be it worship, be it aarti, be it kakar aarti, anything. And parayan is obviously another way of gathering Baba's blessings. And another thing that I would like to say is chant. Chant Baba's holy name, please. Every day, at least 108 times, that is one round. And chant loudly so that the holy name reaches your ears as well. Okay, that is another way you can get rid of all the problems. This world is known as Dukkhalayam Ashashvatam, as referred to in the Bhagavad Gita. So you can't expect yourself to be dry after diving in a swimming pool, right? So this world is Dukkhalayam. Here you will get miseries. This is a place of miseries. This is a place of sadness. This is a place of problems. You can't get rid of the problems. But problems will always be there. We must make ourselves that much what to say, immune to those problems, so that they do not bother us in our future. The holy name of the Lord will act as a shield, act as a bubble that will ultimately protect us from all sorts of mishaps of this world, of this dukkhalayam ashashvatam. Problems will be there, but if we chant the holy name, if we serve Baba, those problems will not bother us. Okay? So those problems will protect us like a shield in this material world, where we are always drenched with problems. Okay. So this was the benefit of Brahma Murta Parayan. Brahma Murta Parayan is definitely very much meritorious. Okay? Even it will help you in your material aspects as well as in your spiritual progress. We must pray to Baba that in this very lifetime we must break the cycle of birth and death. We must reach to His holy abode from where there is no return to this material world. We must not be born again. In this very lifetime we must attain You. This must be our mode of devotion, and every single day of this life is a preparation for the final exams that we are going to appear for. That is the time when life comes to an end. That is the final exam for which we are preparing every moment, every single second of this life. Chanting of the holy name, why are we encouraging chanting so much? Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, He took the incarnation just to preach the holy name of the Lord. Even all the Shastras compiled together give us the only remedy to get rid of the material world is chanting of Lord's name. The efficacy of chanting Lord's name. Even Sri Sai Satcharitra glorifies chanting of Lord's name like anything. Why so? We need to keep this in our regular practice, the chanting of Lord's holy name, because that is the only ultimate thing that will carry us safely across this worldly existence to His divine abode. Okay? Lord Shri Krishna says that in this Kali Yuga, I have taken the Naam Avatar. Baba exists in this world still in the form of His holy name. Okay? His holy name is the thing that can take us to Him ultimately. Is there any issue with my voice again? Just let me know once. Because I am getting some comments. Just write yes or no whether my voice is clear or not. It's clear? Okay. So the devotees who are saying that my voice is not clear, there might be some technical difficulty or some problem with the network connection over there. Kindly check that. Okay. So what I was saying, yes, to reach Baba's holy abode, we must strive day and night to chant His name. We must take out time at least once in a day to chant His name, so that we develop the habit of chanting His name gradually. After each passing day, we must develop the habit of chanting the holy name, so that at the end, while death approaches us, we are able to remember God at that time, and we are able to break the cycle of birth and death and reach Baba from where there is no return, and we will be able to get the bliss of Baba's darshan all the time. We will be able to interact with Baba all the time. We will get Him. What else is needed? And if you just go through the religious scriptures, our Vedic scriptures, the Bhagavatam, the Gita, it will really help you a lot. It will really help you a lot. So this is the way we must worship Him. And Pritamji, if we chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, will it be considered as Baba's Seva, or do we have to chant Baba's name separately? Baba is Himself Krishna. You may chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Even I make sure that I chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra every single day, because it was a mantra given to us in this Kali Yuga as the Yuga Dharma for practice by Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And I believe yuga as the yuga dharma for practice by Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And I believe that it was Baba's order directly, because in Sri Sai Satcharitra also, Baba, if you remember the story of Baba and Bhagat Malsapati, that Baba used to say that you keep your hands on my heart and check whether Hari Nam is going on. So even Baba chanted the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. So why not us? Okay. So the next question, the following question is, any of your best miracle that Sai has showered on you? Yes, all the miracles are the best ones. Each and every day with Baba is a Thursday, and each and every moment with Baba is a miracle. He is there with us physically. That is more than enough for us. It's a great gift for us that He has given us His divine company. And even now I am interacting with you all. He is sitting here and listening to all of you, all your questions. And He is inspiring me to answer the questions. I just have the questions with me. I have not prepared any answer, not prepared any script for answering your questions. It is He who is directly inspiring me, and I am answering your questions. I hope I am able to clear your doubts, at least 1%. I hope that. And there is a prayer appeal also, that my CT scan reports will come on Thursday, as I have severe gastric problem. Yes, our sincere prayers for all the devotees are always with all of you. There are numerous messages each and every day I get from the family members of my Sai family that please pray for me. I always reply that my prayers are always all with all of you, because I make sure that I chant at least one round for all of you. Daily I continue this practice. I pray for mass welfare to Baba, not only the devotees of my Instagram family. I pray to Him in general for the world, for the devotees throughout the world, that wherever, at whichever corner your devotees are, just keep them well, do all good in their lives. This is my prayer each and every day when I worship Him. I convey all your namaskars to Him. Okay? Now, aap Baba se kitni years se pyar karte ho? So I am associated with Baba since I was in class 3. Right now I am doing my masters. So since I was in class 3, when I was in class 1, since then my mother started worshipping. But as I grew up, as I saw each single day, I became devoted to Baba from that very young age. As I said, that before that I was very much devoted to Ma Durga. I used to worship her. And yes, I had a spiritual life from the very young age, from the childhood itself. Even I request all the family members of this Instagram family, Sai Foundation family, that please chant in front of your children. Chant in front of your children, do religious practices in front of your children so that they are inspired with your service. Okay, I guess time is falling short. I need to wrap up very quickly because this call will be disconnected the moment 59 minutes is reached. They disconnected automatically. So, somebody is asking to post Sai Baba quotes. Yes, see, it's very difficult to bring everything under one roof. This page is serving devotees by sharing Leelas, and by Baba's grace, it has reached to the world's topmost position. It is the only page in the world that shares so many Leelas each day. And it has crossed the 5,000th mark of the Leelas. There is an immense stock of Leelas. Even if I miss to post someday, you all can revise the Leelas. You can revisit the old Leelas that I posted in this page. So I'll try to make some other arrangement for posting Baba's quotes. I'll definitely try to. Already there are many devotees who are carrying out this seva and doing that very effectively. Yes, Baba has come from Shirdi. Okay, Baba has come to Kolkata from Shirdi. Okay. So, Hare Krishna, हमारे scriptures में बताया गया है कि parents की सेवा करना भगवान की सेवा करने से भी बढ़कर है. लेकिन बाबा सिखाते हैं कि हमें material attachments नहीं रखने चाहिए, तो हम parents की सेवा करते हुए भी materially attached कैसे ना होए उनसे? Om Sai Ram. Okay, so this is a wonderful question. See, serving your parents, I don't think, is a material attachment. It's your duty. And it is very much mentioned in the scriptures as well, that children must look after their parents. You all must have heard the story of Bhakt Pundalik. Okay? Pundalik got Vitthalji's darshan for the first time while he was serving his parents. So, a devotee attained Krishna while serving his parents. So, just think how efficacious it is on our part that serving the parents is equivalent to serving Krishna himself. Isn't it? So, serving our parents is not, first of all, a material attachment. That is our duty. Material attachment is like for money, hankering after money, for hankering after fame, sensual pleasures, etc. These are the material pleasures. Serving our parents is our duty. Parents are the incarnations of God in this earth. Baba cannot stay personally with each and everyone. So that is why he has created parents who can nurture us, who have brought us up. Today, if we know Baba, if we are able to chant Baba's name, it is because of them. Because our mothers were our first gurus. They have taught us who is Sai Baba, who is Lord Krishna, who is Ma Durga, who is all the who are all the manifestations. So it is because of them today we are existing. It is because of them that we know the our Ishtadev, and we are serving them. So serving our parents is somewhat a service to our gurus. They are our initial gurus from whom we have got this spiritual taste in this life. Obviously, Baba's grace is always there. And so this is how I guess I have cleared your doubt in this very short time, because this call may be disconnected at any point of time. So this is how scriptures में जो बताया गया है कि पेरेंट्स की सेवा करना भगवान की सेवा करना है, इसका उदाहरण, इसका जीवंत उदाहरण हमारे सामने है भक्त पुंडलिक का जो उदाहरण है, जिन्होंने अपने पिता माता की सेवा करके भगवान विट्ठल का प्यार प्राप्त किया, भगवान विट्ठल का दर्शन प्राप्त किया. एंड बाबा इज नन अदर देन लॉर्ड विट्ठल हिमसेल्फ. ही ऑलवेज मूव्ड अराउंड विद दैट ब्रिक पीस एंड शिरडी फॉल्स इन द पंडरपुर क्षेत्र ओनली. So we believe that Baba is Vitthal's incarnation, Baba is Shri Krishna himself, the Kali Yuga incarnation of Shri Krishna himself, to set all the matters, the religious matters, right on this earth. Okay, so this is how I hope I am able to clear your doubt, at least for a bit. A fragment of your doubt I guess is cleared. Om Sai Ram, already I shared lots of miracles done by Sai Baba, but nowadays I am not able to speak with Sai, I cannot do puja for him. I felt like I am going far from him. Why this is happening? I want to hold him, but why I can't able to believe him like before? Please help me. See, the distance increases between the God and his worshipper when our doubts assail our mind. Okay, I know I'm the one wrong, but I think I need to fight for myself. That's why he gave this like this situation. Yes, situations, all the problems. As I said, that we can't expect a problem-free life. You can't expect that. I am chanting Baba's name. Many devotees may question me that I am chanting Baba's name for so many years. Why am I not free from problems? Arey, problems are a part of our life, isn't it? We must live with the problems that have been bestowed on us, because those are the cleansers. Those problems act as the cleansers which wash away our karma phal, which we have gathered for so many lifetimes. So many lifetimes you cannot imagine. Okay? You can't imagine for how many lifetimes you have gathered so much of sins that we have incurred. And it is just a cleansing process in this life that we have so much problems. Okay? And yes, if you think that the distance is increasing between you and Baba, please pray to him ardently that, no Baba, I don't want such a life without you. Without Baba, a life is a hell. I believe that. Without any God, whichever God you worship, be it any deity, irrespective of the deity you worship, without that deity, I think the devotee's life is like a hell. Okay, so please pray to Baba that I don't want to live a hellish life like this. I want your association. Always, I want your eternal association. So that I am always free from all the worries. I am always engaged in your service. See, engaging yourself in the service of the Lord is a way to ignore the problems. For that moment, your mind is engaged in Baba's worship, right? So for that moment, you are not thinking of your problems. Isn't it? So it is a form of meditation. It is a form of sadhana, which was done in the previous ages. The deity service, it was Yuga Dharma for the Dwapar age. For this Yuga, the Kali Yuga, our Yuga Dharma is to chant Lord's name. Chant the holy name. It's not necessary you will chant Om Sri Sai Nathaya Namo, Om Sai Ram or Hare Krishna Mahamantra, whichever God you love. Let me repeat, let me make it absolutely clear, whichever God you like. Whoever is your Ishtadev, may it be Ganpati Ji, may it be Durga Ma, may it be Shiv Ji, please chant the name of that deity, your beloved deity itself. Because I believe, yes, Supreme Personality is Lord Shri Krishna as mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita. But once the main candle lights all the candles, I don't think that there is any difference between the candles, between all the candles. All the candles will have an individual identity, will have the same power, just like the main personality. That is the thing that I have learned from the Dattatreya Parampara, the Dattatreya tradition, the Guru Charitra, and I am currently doing a Parayana of Swami Samartha's life also. I hope I will be able to share all these scriptures, the audio series of these scriptures in my YouTube channel very soon. Please bless me, so that I can share the Ram Vijay, which I am planning for so many days. But due to my very tight schedule, I am not able to post the videos of Sri Ram Vijay. But I am planning to start the series very soon. Okay. So please pray for me, and please pray for this page also. That may it reach the devotees all across the world. May Baba's greatness, may Baba's Leelas reach the entire world. And may his fame, his Leelas like flood the entire earth. Okay. May this help the devotees all across the world, and may they get benefited from this. So with this positive note, I will bring the live session to an end. Okay. And after this, I have a wonderful thing. I don't know, this call may get disconnected at any point of time. So I would like to share a beautiful message that has been shared by one of the family members of our family, one of the committee members, the core committee members of our family. So she has written, Sai Ram, I wanted to message when I saw the post about the live session. So after I posted the proposal for the live session in this Instagram page, the devotee has proposed a beautiful way that how we can engage ourselves in the worship of Sri Baba. So when I saw first that thought crossed my mind was the words of Himat Pant about discussions. But immediately the inner feeling said that it is similar to Sai's Darbar. So I have always thought how it would have been to be there with Sai when he was physically present. The ambience of Shirdi, when our Sai used to walk around and interact with the devotees. Yes, of course. Bringing those sights in our mind, those mere visualizations in our mind, is a boon for us. Imagining those pastimes of the Lord, they encourage the beautiful thoughts in our mind. Okay. So, the Naam Sapta by Radhakrishna Mai, the Parayan of Bhagavatam Ramayan by Dikshit, to be there when all of this was happening would be a real blessing. Yes, just bringing into play our imagination, just like Himat Pant mentions in Sri Sai Satcharitra Mahagranth, that when those things used to go on in the holy land of Shirdi, just think how meritorious those people were. They got the direct physical contact of the Lord over there, isn't it? And when I saw your post that day morning, I was about to start my Satcharitra Parayan, and these were the thoughts going on in my mind. So the devotee is proposing us to celebrate the week of Ram Navami. Ram Navami is I guess on the 21st of April, as I can see in the calendar. It's on 21st of April. So the devotee, she is one of the core members of our Sai Foundation committee. She has proposed to all the devotees that let us do Naam Saptah on the week before the Ram Navami. So it is on Wednesday. So let's start a week before that. I'll intimate the date to all of you. Let us all together do a Naam Saptah. It will be a great thing. A lot of blessings will be incurred from Baba. It will be highly meritorious for all of you. And I am really grateful to the member of our Sai Foundation family who has proposed such a wonderful thing, that such a wonderful Baba has inspired her to think in this way, to walk on the footsteps of Radha Krishna Mai, such a Mahabhakta she was. And let us do the Naam Saptah. Naam Saptah is chanting Baba's name continuously for an entire week in 7 days. Okay, for all the 7 days, chanting Baba's holy name. This is called Naam Saptah without any break. Dasganu Maharaj himself also used to do this. Radha Krishna Mai used to do this after before every single Ram Navami festival that was held at Shirdi. So this was the thing. If you read the Sri Sai Satcharitra Mahagranth, you will obviously know what is Naam Saptah. So the posts regarding Naam Saptah will be given. I think we are towards the end of this series. The call might get disconnected at any point of time. So it was a great pleasure interacting with all of you. Thank you so much for joining this live interactive session. Thank you for posting your questions. And I hope I was able to answer all of them. I was able to clear all your doubts. Please accept my humble obeisances, all of you. Being in association with Sai devotees is none less than being in association with Baba himself. So I am really very lucky that I am associated with all of you. Our family together in this Instagram platform is, I guess, is a blessing of Baba. He has brought us together. We must have some relation in the previous lives that we have come together in this life also. It was so happy to interact with all of you. I can still get so many comments, and there are so many devotees who have joined this live session from different time zones. So my obeisances to them also at your feet. That thank you so much for the immense love and support that you all have bestowed on us, and you have joined this live session. It was really a great blessing. It was really a pleasure for us to join, to interact. I hope I have done justice with the time that you have spent, with your valuable time that you have spent on this live session. Thank you so much. And yes, I will definitely pray Baba so that he arranges time again, and I am again able to come live very soon. I will come live occasionally. I will interact with all of you. A successful one, because I hope I cleared the doubts of many devotees with the inspiration of Baba, and I'll try to come live as frequently as possible. Thank you so much for the immense love and blessings. Keep blessing, and I always seek your guidance. I always seek your blessings. This page is yours. It is your love and support that is carrying this page forward. And help us sharing Baba's Leelas. Suggest the name of this page to your near and dear ones so that they are also able to get the nectar of Baba's Leelas. So by reading them, reading Baba's Leelas is in a way staying in direct contact with him. So Sai and Sai Katha is the one and the same. Chanting his name is also the same. Thank you so much. Thank you. Om Sai Ram.